Visit Sailrite.com for all your project supplies, tools, and instructions. Did you know that Sailrite has a foam nesting calculator? You can now determine exactly how much foam you need for your particular cut sizes of cushions. Visit the Sailrite website and scroll down to the bottom to where it says Resources. Click on Fabric Calculator. You'll see multiple projects. We want to click on Foam Calculator. This tutorial video will show you exactly how to use the foam calculator to determine the amount of foam that you need to order from Sailrite. Let's get started. By using this calculator, we can nest the panels of foam that are required for your project, no matter the size or the number required. The first thing you need to do is select the type of foam that you want to use. This selection gives you the opportunity to choose a high or a medium density polyurethane foam, or you can select a dry fast foam or a closed cell foam. We're going to select the high and medium density polyurethane foam, and you'll notice that there are different sizes that are available from Sailrite, and the calculator will put those sizes on the screen. So let's hit the next button. Here you can enter the sizes of the pieces of foam that you desire. But before we do that, let's scroll down to this rendering. Here you can see the area in gray is the sizes of sheets of foam that are available from Sailrite, from 24 to 80, 36 to 80, and 48 to 80. So 24 is to here, 36 is from here to here, and 48 is from here to here. And then 80 is obviously all the way down. The areas in yellow here along the sides are the safety areas because sheet sizes of foam may vary slightly. Each one of the grids or squares equals 1 inch. I prefer to add all of the sizes of cushions that I need on my rendering below before I start to move them around and try to nest them. The calculator assumes you're making a rectangle or a square. I've entered 20 for the left side and 15 inches for the top side. Because the calculator assumes a rectangle or a square, it has entered the right side and the bottom side automatically and the diagonal. If your cushion is not a rectangle or a square, you can change those figures. If you need to change the diagonal, it's measured from the upper right corner to the lower left corner. Since this is a rectangle, we're going to leave it at the default of 25 and we'll add this cushion. The calculator adds that cushion to our rendering below, as seen here. Before I start moving it around, I'm going to enter all of my foam pieces. So my next size I'm going to enter is 30 inches for the left side and 25 for the top side. We're going to make a rectangle again. Add that cushion, and you can see it here at the upper left corner of our grid. And for our final cushion, we're going to add an irregular cushion. So our left side will be 40, our top side will be 15, our right side will be, let's say, 45, and our bottom side will be 35. The diagonal is measured from the upper right corner to the lower left corner. The diagonal is crucial to angles at the four corners. Measure it carefully from the lower left corner to the upper right corner. Let's go ahead and click the Add Cushion button now. If you do not enter a diagonal, the calculator will assume a 90 degree right angle at the upper left corner, as seen here. Now that we have all the pieces on our foam, we can nest them. So we'll just click our mouse button and move each of the pieces around, obviously to the right side of our foam, to see if we can buy a smaller sheet size of foam. So I will nest them as close as possible to each other, so lines are basically right on top of each other, but stay in our yellow safety zone if possible. So here you can see we have foam directly on top of each other, and that's really something that I don't want to happen. So what I can do is I can actually rotate this upper panel by clicking the rotate button here and then clicking that panel, and it's rotated. And now it fits within our foam sheet. And then we can move this one up so that lines are just touching, and you'll notice that everything fits perfectly now. And we are also in the yellow safety zone for almost all of our foam here, here, and the lines are on top of each other here. They're not touching here. We're in the safety zone here. Now down here, we're a little bit close, but we're probably gonna be fine. So all three of these cushions fits on a 36 by 80 inch sheet of foam that we can order from Sailrite. Let's go ahead and delete these cushions, and we'll start from scratch and do something a little bit more difficult. We're going to randomly put some different size cushions on our foam here. If you'd like to add two of the same size, just hit the Add Cushion button more than once, obviously. And we're going to put a few different random sizes and some irregular cushions on this. But we're still trying to fit within the 36-inch parameter here for us to try to hold the costs down. So now we'll start nesting all of these panels and try to get them to fit within that piece of foam. They obviously don't fit, even if we rotate some of the panels. So what we're going to do is we're going to add another sheet of foam. You can see here that we're rotating a few panels more than once, which is quite possible to do to get them to fit. Now we need another sheet of foam, so I'm going to go up to the Add One Foam Sheet. And if we scroll down, there's another sheet of foam in three different sizes, as you can see. You can also hit the right mouse key and you'll have a pullout where you can make your desired selection. So don't forget that as you scroll down and you get more sheets of foam, it's a little bit hard to scroll up to hit those buttons. So just click the right mouse key for the pullout. You can continue to experiment to get these cushions to fit within your foam so that you get the optimal use of your foam. We're just rotating this one several times until we get it where we want it. We're going to possibly flip this one, and that puts the longer line to the right, which is what I like, and I'm going to flop it as well, and I don't like that as well, so I'm going to flip it again. Okay, that's much better. But let's challenge it a little bit. Let's put in a very large irregular cushion here that goes off of our 36 by 80 inch sheet that we're trying to fit it on. Now we could obviously just order the 48 by 80, but again, I'm trying to hold costs down. So I added another sheet of foam and we'll pull this one down to that third sheet of foam and try to fit it there. And you notice it does not fit. So we need to slice it. We haven't gone over that yet. So to slice, you need to have your cushion either off to the right side or to the bottom. So let's hit the slice button and see what happens. Oh, we got an error warning. Because the calculator can only slice objects that have two corners outside the gray, to the right or to the bottom, this error message will appear unless you have two corners outside that area. So you can see here we have one corner out. Now we have two corners out. And we can slice again. We need to make sure this corner is all the way off, outside of our yellow safety zone and out of the grids. And now let's slice. Yep, that works. We have a cushion that's showing in green here, and it can easily be glued together. So I can nest this someplace else. I can't nest it here because there's no room, but I can move it up to, say, this sheet of foam. Now it doesn't fit here, but again, I'm going to hit my right mouse key and do some magic here by either flipping or flopping or rotating, and we can experiment. This looks like the perfect option here. Now I'm still touching other cushions here, but we can actually rotate or flip or flop them to try to get those to fit better as well. So let's try to do an action here. Let's try to rotate it. Rotate it doesn't work. Let's rotate it one more time. That's a little bit better. Will we get it to fit here? Probably not. So I'm going to flop this one vertically. And that looks like a perfect fit. I'm a little bit outside of the yellow safety zone, but that's probably going to be okay. so I can order 3 sheets of 36 by 80 inch and fit all of my cushions within those 3 sheets. You'll notice also that the markings here tell you what size to cut it, and they also tell you what pattern or cushion it is. This is pattern 5, and obviously it goes with the pattern 5 here as well. So you can use those to cut this foam to size once you receive it. Now, what if I don't want to glue foam together? So let's delete these panels that we just put on here that we had to slice. So we're going to hit the delete button and then click on those that we want to delete. And let's go back up to the top and add that cushion again because our measurements are still there. We'll drag it down to the third sheet of foam down at the bottom here. And you'll notice it fits perfectly within a 48 by 80 inch sheet of foam. So because of that, I could order a 36 by 80 inch one, two, and then I can order a 48 by 80, and then I don't have to do any gluing of foam sections. Let's go over one more thing about the fabric calculator for cushion nesting. Many cushions are shaped like a keystone, as shown here in the rendering. Because of that, we have designed the software to center the longer side over the shorter side if the other two sides are equal. An example is the top side being 15 inches, the bottom side 25, and the left and right sides are 20. Click the Add Cushion button, and here you can see an example of a keystone cushion. Notice that the longer bottom side is centered between the top side, which is shorter. Now, if you like, you can print out your results. Simply go to the upper left of your browser, click on File, then click on Print, and then follow the prompts. To buy your foam, visit the Sailrite website. Click on Shop, then click on Foam, and we'll shop for all foams. You can choose the type of foam you need here. We're going to click on Upholstery Foams, and then you can pick out the foam and the size and the density and the firmness that you want. If you have any questions, give us a call or email us. We're glad to help. I'm Eric Grant, and from all of us here at Sailrite, thanks for watching.